Hello, good evening, welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews, Tasty Tuesday. Lovely to see yous all. I'm hoping there's going to be a few in, because I've kind of sprung it on you with some beers that some of yous go, can't get that one, can't get it. Got a lager, for any lager drinkers. I've got a pale ale, for kind of, we're going to move up a little bit. We've got a Trappist, one of the 8 Trappist beers out there. And that's what we got this week. So I'm hoping you've got all your things all ready. Nils Oscar, really, really good lager. It was, up until just this week or last week at the GBBF, or just after the GBBF, it was the best lager I've ever tasted. But it's been beat. It's been beat. So, you know, if you don't buy what, take a look at all me bleeding stuff and that, you know, keep up with it. I'm hoping you've got them in. I'm going to have a quick check on the old comments and see what we've got, see who we got in and what they're saying. Anyone? Nah, it's just me. Let's have a little, I have to refresh these. And, yay! Derek says, evening tell, unfortunately no money left for beer this month. What's the matter with you? So joining in drinking what I've got in the fridge, Samuel Smith Oatmeal Stout, that's nice, and St. Austell 1913 Stout. I had that at the beer festival, and that was superb. Done to an old, kind of old recipe that they kind of dug out of their books and whatever, you know. And Connie says, evening! Lovely to see you, lads. Lovely to see you in. So let's kick off and see what we've got. First one. Gould Lager, Gould. It's kind of like the proper Cockneys and that from years ago. Even I'm not proper, like, you're right, geezer, all that business, you know. They used to say, like, God, instead of God, they'd say Gould. Oh, my Gould. You know, like that, you know, kind of Albert Steptoe sort of Gould. Oh, my Gould, father, you dirty old man. And I, oh, Harold, yeah, you dirty old man. Sorry. I've gone off, you know. So, open your Goulds up. Open your Nils Oscar up. And, sorry, licking me lips in front of you there. That's not nice, is it? I'll have a quick check. Mickey Lopez says, yo, dudes. I only got the tribute. What's going on here? I'm going to be drinking on my own, I think. Did anyone actually get the Gould Lager? It was, it's available in Waitrose and Tesco's. You know, you let me down, boys. You know. It's getting a bit sad now. Anyway, I'm going to crack it open because I love this lager. I really do. Thought I'd lost me BB Barfly for a minute. I'm sitting surrounded by boxes now. My kind of box corner is no longer a cupboard. It's kind of I'm just getting gear sent to me left, right and centre. And I ain't complaining, you know. But it's I can't keep up. Yes, I'll have people, yeah, I'll help. Right, yeah. Let's crack the top of this. Really beautiful top, really beautiful crown. Lovely, fantastic, gorgeous. Oh, you can't see it, can you? Look, bloody, here we go. Look at that. Isn't it lovely? Little tiny picture of Nils Oscar himself on there from many years ago. You can't see it, can you? Can you see it now? Nope. Epoxy lighting and everything. Well, there you go. Very pretty. If you've got one, you can see it yourself. If you ain't, well, what can I say? Well, I'm going to pour it in my very, very posh, little salubrious glass here from the festival. You know, you got these down at the festival, and the little ones, if you wanted a little glass, I've got all sorts. I was there 4 out of 5 days. So I'm going to just pour it just a little bit in. Because I want a little bit of swirly room. One thing, bad thing with these glasses is that once you get up to a third, which is up there, you've got no room to do anything. So I'm going to swirl it in, swirl a little head on there if you want a little head. So that's what it looks like. It's golden. Where's a bit of paper? Bit of paper. There's a festival bag. That'll be nice. Look at there. Look in that. Lovely. That's it. I'm going to use that all the more. Reflects the light in so many lovely little spangles. head dies down quite quickly, but that's good. Right, let's have a little sniff. Tell me what you get, boys, if you are sniffing. Oh, it's lovely. They kind of they use their own barley, their own hops, and everything else here. I think another one who's doing that at the moment is Rogue Brewery in America. But these was doing it quite a while back. You know, they've been, you know, from grain to glass, from barley to bottle, and any other kind of illiterate literations and things like that that you can think of. See how my mind works. I'm like a Sun newspaper writer, I reckon. Headline writer. Right, let's see what you... Ah, Opsine's in. Hey, beer god! Beer god didn't manage to get the god lager. What are you doing? Evening all. Evening. This is a pale ale, isn't it? No, this one's a lager. And that's why it's called god called lager. Come on, Connie, keep up, mate. Sorry, mate, I'm only joking. Right. Let's get back on this. Let's have a little smell and a taste, see if I can tell you what we got. Now, that one thing I like about things like this, they're a little bit more challenging, kind of to describe. You know, you get the ones that are the big hops and things like that, great big woo, and they're a lot easier, it seems, sometimes, unless you've got so much in, like a Harvey's Imperial Russian Stout, where it takes you half hour to just get half of it in, you know. But anyway, it's quickly getting this. Nice little celery notes, nice little kind of lettuce notes and things like that, but in a nice way. Little, really gentle little peppery notes. Little kind of sugar snap background, but not sweet, if you know. Does that make sense? Little grapefruit and lemon pith in there. Tiny bit of lemon zest as well. Oh, it just smells so pure and clean and lovely and beautiful. And in clean, in a way, you know, like these McLagers always say clean when they mean pee poor, you know, piss poor, I nearly said. But when I mean piss poor, and it's clean, refreshing. Well, it kind of smells clean and refreshing, but in a good way. Right, I'm going in, boys and girls. Cheers. Chin chin, Nostrovia, and all that business, and cheers, and bottoms up. Up your bottoms up. That's good. That is quality, quality, quality. That's quality with a capital K, that is. Really good quality stuff. Right, let's have a little look, see what anyone's got to say. None of you is a guy. Citrusy! Connie's just got one. Good lad. Citrusy, that one. Reverend says, I just got in, big lad. Oh, I thought you was going to miss us. Just got in, big lad. Sorry I'm late. Yeah, I started without you. But better late than never. Yes, certainly is. Certainly is. Connie's is on the ball, mate, with the little citrusy notes in there. Yes, indeed. Nice little lemony sort of notes. More than on the nose, funny enough. The nose has got biscuity sort of smells there. Little rich teas and little lovely little gentle notes. Almost kind of cucumber sandwiches, it reminds me of. That cucumber, but without the butter. Cucumber sandwiches. When you get over the cricket ground and everything else. Suck at me, I'm so posh. Over the cricket ground and there. Grand. With your cucumber sandwiches. Lovely. Beautiful stuff. Right. Proper kind of thick cut bread in it. Cut bread, that's what I said. Right, let's get on with this. I'm on broadcast mode, you know. Jabber, jabber, jabber. See what anyone's got to say. And, right, we're going to, I think I'm going to drink the last of that. And I'm going to get on. So I've just a little sup more. That is lovely. That really is lovely. I'm going to save the rest of that bottle till later. That is glorious. That really is. Yum, yum. Look, 9 minutes. I ain't messing around, am I? Right, I need another glass. Oh, by the way, you'll see I'm gradually behind. what we're doing next week, because we're going to have a stout week. So we're going on to the tribute. Have you got a tribute? Hey, let's have a tribute on the next one for next week as well. Tribute, Cornish Pale Ale. Now, I always say that different, pale ale, because otherwise I'll say pale ale. Ow. Because I'm so common. Common as Mook. I'm not posh as Pook. Sorry. Right, here is the St. Austell kind of crown, or cap, or whatever you want to call it, as long as you don't mix the two and end up with crap. But that is the crown cap, and it is very lovely. What does it say on there? Since 19... Wait a minute, what's that say? Cool. Magnifying glass. 1851. So that's near since 9 minutes to 7. They started brewing there. Get on with it. Ooh. Right, let's have a glass. Let's have a little posh GBBF glass there. Let's have a little posh one of them. It's a little bit dirty, isn't it? I'm sure it is. Looks a bit smeary. I don't know. Right. I'm going to pour a little bit of head on. How many fingers of head? Let's have a look. There's one finger of head on there. Sorry. I shouldn't really, should I? Right, so this is what it looks like with the little thingy behind there. Look at that, all lovely little spangles and stuff. Look, isn't it lovely? Kind of bronze, golden bronze, maybe. Offering up all sorts of loveliness. Nice gentle carbonation. Nice little kind of white head or off-white head. It's dying down. Tell us what you're getting, boys and girls, or whoever. Tell us what you're getting. Let's hear it from you. Let's hear it from boys. How cold are you drinking it? Actually, the Gold Lager I've had out the fridge for about a half hour or so, and the rest are room temperature, though you should have them slightly more chilled. But I've always found I'd rather err on the side of them being too warm and be able to taste everything in there than to be too cold. You know, so if you've got to get them out of the fridge and you're not sure how long, get them out too early rather than too late, you know. Fridge helps because it helps everything to settle. It helps everything to kind of clear up and everything else, and it all go down to the bottom of the bottles and everything else, you know. So that helps with that. But it doesn't help with the flavour if you've got them too cold. Right, come and tell us what you're getting, because you're a little bit behind me in the, you get a little bit of a lag on these videos. I don't know if you've noticed that. You get something like a minute lag or a minute and a half lag behind. So, by now, what you're looking at, I'll be drinking it probably. I'll certainly be smelling it. Smells nice and light. Yes, it does. I've noticed though there's a slightly darker notes than usual in there. I'm getting kind of right. Let's have one more quick check because I don't want to overlap you guys. I want to give you a little go. Oh yes, old hop scene there, straight in with a beautiful descriptor. Buttercup syrup. Yes, it is. It's got that note. I was just going to say something along the little caramel sort of lines, but he's hitting the nail right on the head there. Buttercup syrup. I love that. See, you get little descriptors when someone else comes up with one. You get a little descriptor and you go, oh, yeah. That kind of was evading your mind. And that's the beauty of tasting beer with other people that love beer. You're not sitting there sniffing it on your own and people going, look, it's a beer sniffer. You know. Anyway, let's put these updates on automatique. Derek! I was off with saying something new. It's all running down again. Now, let's have a look. See if I can bring in some notes. I'm getting like little Werther's original notes in the background. Slightly coppery. Really? Have you tasted it already? Are you cheating? I'm not getting copper on the nose. I'm getting little kind of lemon, almost limey notes. I'm getting something along the lines of dried strawberries, kind of cherry sort of notes in there, but little kind of small ones, just little hints. Let's just twist it again. Twist again. Yeah, kind of lime pith in there as well. And I'm getting something like little hints of panettone in there, like little hot cross bun notes in there, kind of currently fresh baked bread. Nice. One more refill and see what we got. I've got some Murphy Stouts on Friday. How long before I put put it in the fridge for? I ain't got any Murphys up here. We're doing Guinness next week, as well as Fuller's Black Stout, and a little surprise behind there. How long do you put it in the fridge for? Just chill it it's kind of one of them things with those sort of beers. You say you like them. Personally, the canned stouts I like room temperature, and this is my personal thoughts on it. And the canned Guinnesses that are just normal without the kind of nitro in them, I like those cold, you know. And if I go in a pub and have a Guinness, I like it nice and cold as well. It's a strange thing, isn't it? So we've got hop scene. It says sweetened cooking apples. An apple or apple pie. I'm getting cores, little apple cores, but I'm not getting, not on the nose anyway. Yeah, well, I'm going to dive in. I'm getting apple cores on that, but I'm not getting the rest of it. Right, let's dive in, boys and girls. Cheers, bottoms up. Cheers, Nostrovia, Chin Chin, and everything else. Oh, that is lovely. That's a joy, that is. Oh, that is lovely. Right, coming in. Let's have ya. That is really lovely. What is it we had down at the... we went to St. Austell's when we had... I don't know if I had the tribute on there on a different day. But they had some lovely beers on there. We had... what was it we had on there? God, blimey, St. Austell. We had their 1917 Stout, 1913 Stout, I should say, and that was lovely. And we had the Big Jobby. That was it, the Big Job. And Big Jobby was bloody lovely. That was another another one of them little highlights of the festival. I really enjoyed that. Really enjoyed having a beer with my mate old Hopscene that we're talking to on here at the moment. That was lovely as well. Let's have another little twist and a twirl and a smell. Oh, nice. Right, coming in, let's see what we've got. Tell us what you're getting. Hops and malts can taste. Hops and malts can taste. I don't get you, mate. What can hops and malts can taste? Oh, can taste. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not really getting like sort of metal or nothing like that in there. Getting hops and malts and that is all lovely little things. Nice kind of combination of the two. You are getting a nice combination, but I'm getting. Anyway, let's see what else we've got coming in. Nothing. I'm getting kind of, now that I'm thinking of apples, I'm getting toffee apples. I'm getting like a kind of little bit of toffee apple sort of taste. More the candy off of it. You know when you get not the red candy, you get the kind of better browner candy. The kind of cooked sugar sort of candy. I'm getting that sort of flavour in the background. I'm getting Werther's Originals. Pardon me. I'm getting shortbread biscuits, lovely melt in the mouth ones. Big Job was terrible in the bottle, but stunning on cask. I've never had it in the bottle, Rob. Yeah, I've never had that in the bottle, so I'd love to try that out. By the way, boys and girls, let your friends know and everyone else know about the Tasty Tuesdays and that, and everyone on Facebook and that, because I ain't kind of been, you know, whoring it out and that to people, because I didn't really want to whore it out and that, and kind of go, please come see me and all that, but we do need people in, you know. At the moment, we're not getting too many people in. It's kind of a bit. It's still a great joy having a chat and that with you, but we need a few more in. We need it to be a bit of a party, you know. What else we're getting here? Yeah, nice little current notes and little you know when you get them little dried bits of kind of candy oranges and things like that. Sorry, I can taste the flavours of hops and beer. I mean, yeah, in the beer, yeah. I think that's it. Preserved lemons, but what's the little thing? Little candied oranges. It's kind of like little bits of those. You sometimes get them in lemon ices and things, and in cakes and stuff. They're lovely. I can't have them anymore. You know, diabetic and that. Mm-hmm. I just love things like that, cakeys and things. Preserved lemons. Yep, they're in there. But yeah, that's the wonderful thing about beers, is that with just the addition of, mainly in beers, you just got those four ingredients in it, water, yeast, hops and barley in it, you know, and with just those, yeah, you get other things, you get wheat and you get all sorts of different adjuncts and things, but with just those, you can make millions of different beers in it of extraordinarily different flavours. That is one of the things that just is always, it never ceases to astound me. And that's lovely about it. Well, I'm going to just down the last of this, so give us your taste notes in there a bit quick. Cheers, everyone. Chin chin. Mm. Oh, that's lovely. That is nice. Let's get another glass. Let's get that one. Sorry, we're not drinking that. And we're having the chimmy. Or chimmy. I bet somebody's looking forward. I hope somebody's looking forward to this. Anyway, let's have a quick refresh on the old comments. And nope, nothing else in. Right, keep it up, guys. Keep it up. Keep with me. Chimay, this one's a little bit stronger, so that's why I left it till last. We're talking 9% on, as Danny would call it, the old Richter scale. This is a beer de Scormore. A bit not to down de Scormore, actually. It just says on the other, a beer de Scormore. But this is one of the eight Trappist breweries. So good. So let's crack this open. I think they do a red, white, and blue in the colours, and of the tricolours and things like that. Oh, is it fizzy? I know the blondies. Yeah, no, we're all right, I think. I think it shook up its own yeast, though. You got no chance of that being clear. I can actually see the yeast has gone and started clouding up. Lovely. There's the very beautiful crown. Really lovely, I like that. Another one of those crowns that I just think, yep, lovely. Crowns should look nice. They should do the job most importantly, but they should look nice. Really enjoyed the proper job. Yeah, you should try the big job. Ooh. It's like proper job turbocharged. Yeah, right, that's Mickey. Lovely stuff, Mickey. Right. Oh, what's happened? I go to Brussels frequently. Beers taste so good over there. Yeah, I know. I've got to go over there. I'm kind of, I'm planning hopefully to go before Christmas, maybe, or something like that. Maybe for my birthday or something like that. It would be nice. But I ain't telling you when it is or how old, so shut up. I don't do birthdays. Just pour this out while I'm jabbering away. So maybe for me 25th birthday or something like that, I'll go over there, spend a weekend or something over there. Because it's kind of one of them things where I think you probably spend less money going over there than you would, say, a visit to Scotland or somewhere, you know. I'm pouring a lot in here, yeast and all. So, because I like the yeasting on this one, and where it's dark, you can't really moan about it. But I do suggest you try every beer you get, especially bottle-conditioned beers. I do suggest you try everything with the yeast in, with the yeast out first. Try it, pour some yeast in, try it again, because you get sometimes you get two completely different beers. One I had the other day was one of the few I've preferred with the yeast out, and that was God blimey, what's the Duvel. The Duvel, not the triple hop one, the other one. And that was like kind of champagne almost without the yeast. With the yeast in, it suddenly got banana-y and kind of like hid its little subtleties. Anyway, I've gone off the remit here. The head on that has died down, but I kind of weren't expecting that 9%. I know there are beers with 9% will hold an head and everything else, but they seem to die down a little bit quicker. That glass looks lovely. But, yeah, that's kind of dying down quite quick. But when you twirl it, pumps up again. So you are getting carbonation. It's just showing that, you know, there's a fight between the proteins and the alcohol in there. And the alcohol is kind of winning. I'm going to wipe that on the bottom of my shirt because I ain't got a tea towel around here. Oh, wait a minute. I've got a shirt. Hold on. Yeah, there we go. That's it. Right. Still cloudy. And what we got? What's people saying? Let's have a look quickly down here. Brussels, yep. And Reverend says, yes, I got Aspel Organic, so not a good night for me. Oh, Aspel Organic's all right. I'm sure it is. Seem to remember that being an okay one. They're in the long neck. Long neck bottle, they're in the long neck bottle then once, if I remember. And Dippy's a new one. Way, hello Dippy. nice to meet you, mate. Dippy. Oh my God. I've just found out who Dippy is, and I'm gonna grass her up because Dippy is only able to get tribute. Happy Days, Sacking the Shopper, Foster's Nikki GBBF. She was working down at GBBF. I teased her kind of, relentlessly. She was working at the GBBF, one of the kind of volunteers that was doing a great job, and a great girl and everything, doing a brilliant job. But she confessed to me that she's a Foster's drinker as well. How dare you? So, you know, if you listen, Nikki, if you get a bit of lambasting and everything else, Nickers, as I call her, as you, if you get a little bit lambasted and told off and everything else, don't take no notice, because, you know, it's going to happen. But, yes, you missed a good lager, wherever it was, Gould Lager, you missed it, and we've already had the tribute. So you're too late for that. Where you been? And we're on the chimmies. So, boys and girls, what's up, singer? Connis, have you been to Cantillon in Brussels? That's one of the places I'd love to go, that is. I so would love to go there. See all that snow and stuff all over. Well, it looks like snow. Snow and all that all over the, all over everything. They got yeast just on everything. And Rob says, I'm using the Roquefort Chalice. for this, like a massive beer pond. It's true, isn't it? Yeah, I'll drink it out of an old slipper. I always think that, yes, a good different glassware and stuff, it does make a little bit of difference, you know, but this, there is a lot of beer ponsity to things like this, you know, there's a lot of beer snobbery. And yeah, I think beer can be, good beer can be drunk out of a jam jar and you know, even Goolagong slippers or whatever. If it's a good beer, it's a good beer, you know, and if you put Foster's in a Chalice, it's still going to be Foster's, you know. Love my Foster's, it's dirty. You're disgusting. You disgust me, Dippy. You really do. Right. It's not right. It's terrible. Let's see how we go with this. Tell me what you got. Have a sniff. Come on. Work at it. Ooh. Big alcohol notes on there, but kind of not just there for numbers. They're there to carry that, all those lovely flavours and everything. You know, as soon as I smell this, I'm thinking what sort of foods it can go with and things like that, you know. Talk about beer ponds, didn't you? You know. So I drink it and I, that'll go well with a Roquefort or something like that. I'll go well with a bit of blue cheese or something like that. Oh, that smells lovely. Right, I'm getting a bit of Christmas pudding, I'm getting currants, I'm getting... I'm getting well-baked bread, kind of like when you get like almost a hard crust almost on them. You know, quite darkly baked bread. And Garibaldi biscuits. Oh, delicious and nutritious. Come on, tell me what you're getting. I think you're about a minute or so behind me, I'm sure you are. Foster, love my Fosters, it's dirty, that's disgusting. How can you come on here with your, like, shouting about your lovely Fosters, isn't it? Nicky, what else do you drink, Dippy? What else do you drink? Dippy 106. Because you can't be down at the GBBF and drink Fosters all the time. It's terrible. Well, I'm going to dive in a minute, so let's just wait for a little bit longer. I'm getting tiny hints of kind of a, like a latte or something like that, like milk chocolatey, not milk chocolate, like a light chocolate, around that sort of 30% sort of region, with a little hint of coffee in there as well. Nice little bitterness on the nose. Cranberry. Connie's. Yeah, you could be right, mate. Marzipan and damson. Yum, yum, yum. They're proper wine ponds, like descriptors, eh? I mean, sorry, mate. Yes, actually, yeah, you do get a little hints of the old marzipan. Damsons, yeah, tiny, tiny little bits in there. Well, you've got strong alcohol taste and cranberries, yeah. Yeah, you're getting that as well. Right, let's dive in. Cheers, everyone. Chin chin, bottoms up, and up your bottoms and everything else. Cheers. Good Lord. That's a big beer, isn't it? That is big. That's bigger than the bottle. What we're talking 330 millilitres in there, and that is a big, big beer. That's why I think sometimes you get these beers that are in small bottles. I hate these small bottles when you get a little 330 bottle of something 4 ABV or something like that. It's ridiculous. But you get a beer like that and you go, that is big. That's a lot bigger than a kind of than bigger than a pint sort of thing. That's kind of like drinking a couple of pints. It's like a meal, that is. What we got, what we say. Let's have a quick look. Refresh again. Cantillon is very central. 10 minutes walk from Brussels Midi station. I think we've got a trip planned in here, guys. I think we're going to have to all take a trip to Brussels. Right. I'm going to have another go in, see if I can bring some stuff out. you're getting kind of burnt off the edges. Funny enough, again, little toffee apple edges. And proper toffee apple, you know, when you kind of make your own and everything else like I used to before I got the diabetes and it. Yeah, proper toffee apples. What else have got we got saying here? I made the mistake of doing that automatic things. Lovely taste to me. A little like Leffy. Yes, kind of that Leffy Broom sort of, excuse me. That Leffy Broom sort of thing going on there. I think it's those Belgium yeasts and that going behind there. Now and again, you get little tiny little like kind of flambé banana notes in there. Look at me. Barbecue bananas in my case. Sugary sweet, rum and raisins, boozy and but very drinkable. It is drinkable, but I don't think you could down it very easy. You know? It's not one of them you could sort of la la la, yum yum yum. I think you would struggle with a couple of them, you know, with like 230 ml bottles. I think that would be like you're eating a big meal in there in a glass. It is drinkable, but it's and it's delicious, but I don't know if I could manage too many of them, you know. I think you'd have to take your time with those and sit there sipping it. And what else we got? Derek says... That sounds good, yeah, isn't it? Shall be sending the missus out for one of those tomorrow along with the stats. What, ye old Chimay? Yes, the old Chimay. Or Chimmy, as I call it, because I'm common. Common as mook. Let's have one more taste. I love that rum, sort of, rum and raisin. By the way, I know I tell you this every week, and I hope you are listening, you guys and girls. Go and see our Rob from Hop Scene. He's got his own website, hopscene.com, and he's also got his own YouTube account and everything. Excuse me, I'm going to just wipe myself here. I'm bloody boiling. Got his own YouTube account and everything as well. And he's very knowledgeable. He's taste descriptors are really good, and you know it's just a pleasure watching him. He really is. He's one of the guys I like watching on here, and I kind of don't like to watch. I ain't gonna get into it, but he's one of the guys I find he's straight down the line. He's an honest reviewer. He says it how it is, but he's also knowledgeable as well, which is refreshing. So one more quick update. Whey! There be anything frisky, hoppy, mainly pale ales. Good girl. Lovely stuff. On 106, Jack FM. Ah, Jack FM. I don't know what Jack FM is, but now we've got what 106 is. 1648 Royal Britannia. Summer Skills, Bunker Hill. Yeah, that was nice. I tell you what, you've got to try some of the Summer Skills in bottles. They're frightening. Have a look at my Summer Skills reviews. I think I've got one where I've got 4 pints of just pure froth. So there was a nightmare, they was. And I think they looked like there was a little bit hard to kind of serve as well. They looked a bit frothy. I don't know. I won't ask you to say, you know, in case you get yourself in trouble or anything. What we got? That sounds good. I always miss these. I've got the Chimay Red in the cupboard, but not the blue. That was our Beer Lover, 1983. Connie says it's a beer to take your time with. Yeah, I believe so, definitely. Burpee, though. As much as there's no head on it, they certainly put carbonation in there. I use this when cooking beef carbonara. Nice, very posh. I use with a lot of things like beef. I'll use stouts myself. You know, occasionally I'll use some things like a Merlot or something like that. Some rich, something Resinato. It depends if I need something really sugary, but otherwise it'll be a nice rich stout. I don't think I've got one on it up here that I'd use. I use things like Foreign Extra Stout. Really gets whoa, big beefy sort of beefy notes in there, you know. Right. And anything frisky and all that business. Yep, frisky. Lovely. Gonna have one more little sip of this and I think we might call it a day. Try Grimbergen Brun. Do you know what? I've never tried that one. Fine Belgian beer. Connie, that's one that I think I might have to try. Well, I'm gonna steam this down. Quickly get a few taste notes in if you've got any. Otherwise, by all means, still have a chat with each other and everything, you know. And I'll probably slip a few little comments in as well. But I might do another beer review as well while I'm here. I've got a couple of alcohol-free beers as well that I've got to do at some point. Life's hard, isn't it? I've also got the old... look, I've got hold of that one. Yeah. Bit of Maiden. And just down the road to me, though. Well, just down the road to where I used to live. I've actually jammed with one of the guys from Maiden, Iron Maiden. The early Iron Maiden, out of the first album. Pardon me. Weyland's Sixpenny was 106 Jack FM. All right, yeah. Just checked the GBBF program. Ah, nice stuff. Lovely stuff. Well, I hope you earn more festivals then, girl. Because I do like to rub someone up the wrong way, and you know, sort of get a bit cheeky and naughty, and how can you do that? You're out of order. Some people just ain't got a sense of humour to put up with it. They go, what? But yeah, you had a good sense of humour, you put up with me and it. So that was nice. Right, let's get this down, let's get it on the road and on the show. Sorry, put that round the other way. Yeah, Connie's just reminded me. Fuller's Black Cab Stout. What's on for next week, says Reverend? Yes, Fuller's Black Cab Stout next week. We're having a stout night next week. So Fuller's Black Cab Stout. The old regular can of the old Nitro Draft Guinness. Not quite sure why I call it Draft Guinness, because it's a bit of an oxymoron. You can't have draft in a can, surely. And oyster stout. And it's actually made with no oysters in it. So one of those things. But oyster stout there, without any oysters in it. Guinness draft with the nitro in it. And black cab stout from Fuller's. Excuse me, burping again. Right, guys and girls. A real absolute pleasure, as usual, having a chat with you this week. Tell all your friends, tell everyone on YouTubes and Facebooks and everything else, because we do need a few people in, because it's a little bit quiet. There's, four of us, five of us in, something like that. And it's very warm in here. I'll see you all next week. Take care of yourselves. Look after yourselves, look after each other. And I'll see you next time. Don't be late. I'll start about you. Biddly boo. Bye bye. I've got to shake it down there, you know. It's not really, it's not impressive, is it? I should have been ready. Bye.